Well, I was just cutting with the torch and I had a hot ember go down my ear. Oh, it hurt so bad. You know, here at Jackson Express, safety is really not that important. We do like it, but it always takes second place to getting the job done first. Joking aside, we do take safety as a priority here at Jackson Express. If you've been following us on social media or seen some of our videos, you'll see that we wear respirators, got eye protection, ear protection. It's just all part of polishing. There are some dangers involved, but we try and make safety a priority. Also, with the actual buffing wheels, get you some safety flanges. We use safety flanges here at Jackson Express. One thing to note with the buffing wheel, when you put it on the polisher or fixed speed grinder, make sure that that little flap of fabric is going in the same direction as the way that you are buffing. And once you get all set up with safety, go on and get that shine on. Yeah.
Thinking that the argon tank got left on?
Yep. Yeah, I had it chucked full yesterday. Went out to the shop this morning, bone dry. Might as well burn a couple $20 bills. Oof.
Oh, I seriously hate burning money.
I don't know whose fault it was, but I'm gonna find out.
Idiot. Whoever left the argon is no longer going to be on.
You're
going to
be fired.
Fired.
With a capital F.
Fired.
I'm going to call them up right now. You're fired.
You're done. Fired.
Fired.
You're fired.
Fired. Fired. Out of here. Fired.
Not polishing, usually you can find us with a torch or a welder or a grinder, sander, or a paint gun. We really enjoy anything in the automotive world. Each year we try to do a project. This year we've been working on a 72 Chevy Cummins conversion, and it's going to turn out sweet. I know we haven't shown a lot of video footage of it, but it's going to be pretty sweet. The motor's done and the frame is done and the suspension is built, and hopefully we'll have some more videos of that to come. We really enjoy our hobbies, and that's kind of what we do for fun. We find a lot of fun in our work, and we don't do a lot of extracurricular activities because we find a lot of fun in our work every day. We usually are working on anything from our 95 Kenworth to our 1950 Cadillac to our 72 Chevy Cummins conversion. We find a lot of satisfaction in our hobbies and in our work. I think the thing that we enjoy so much about the world that we're in is every single day you're able to find satisfaction in your work. You can see it immediately. And I think you can go home each day and know exactly what you've done, the progress that you've made, and see your work. There's a lot of jobs out there where you don't know if your work's making a difference or not. You can't see it, but in the polishing world, you see it from the second you do it, and that has brought a lot of satisfaction to us for sure. You show the lights won't stop me, turn to stone. You shine me when I'm alone.
Call me, 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 call me I think the key to polishing is keeping lots of heat on it. Yeah, you need the heat and melt your stuff. Yeah, it just, you need the heat and I don't know, what's the heat do? Cross cut first and then you go your direction you want to finish. Usually I've been figuring out that you only need like two cuts. And so you want to go one direction and then bring your next direction in the way you want to finish. Experience you need first, which took me a while, but bad polisher, well, good polisher, bad polisher. You gotta, I don't know. Would be someone that doesn't have any experience. And so, and that was me at one point. Bad polisher.